point.
Let's get some brief final thoughts. Sarah, we'll start with you.
Oh, Alicia, look, I just want to firstly say congratulations to Daniel Andrews and Labor. Obviously, it was a convincing win. For us as Liberals, I want to thank everyone who voted for us, all our members and supporters. We have got a lot of soul-searching to do. We will review the election result. We will rebuild. There have been some green shoots, I think. I think the win in Q is very significant in terms of the shine coming off the Teals. I'm very hopeful that both David Southwick and also John Pesutto can get up. But clearly a lot of work for us ahead. Congratulations to Matthew. We did, as he pointed out, get a 4% swing in our favour, 2pp. If we did that again, we would be successful at the next election. So I think that gives us as Liberals hope. But of course, tonight is Daniel Andrews and Labor's night, and we can't take that away from him. Okay.
Heidi.
Labor's got to get on with it now. You've made all these promises. You've got all this money to spend. You've got all these freebies to give away. You've got the challenges of the health system that you now have the job of having to sort out. You've got to find the staff. You've got to get some things back on track. But for the Liberal Party, I think, as Sarah said, there's some soul-searching to do. I'd say there's some blame gaming to get through first. Yeah. Matthew Guy was supposed to be the greatest hope for the Liberal Party electoral success this time around. It hasn't eventuated. It didn't even pick up the 11 seats that were lost in 2018. There's going to have to be some pretty serious changes made, and not a lot. I know you've said green shoots, but there's not a lot of fresh blood that's come into the lineup today. Not a lot of fresh talent.
Yeah. I will just say the switch that we made in our campaign to invest so much into health, to respond to the health crisis, that of course then triggered Labor to make a whole lot of commitments in health, and that's a very good thing for all Victorians. So hopefully we will see an enormous amount of investment in health to try and get our health system back on track.
But right.
Final thoughts of John Brumby?
Well, it's nice, you know, it's always nice to be on the winning side, and you know, and that's what we saw tonight, and I think that trend was clear pretty early on. There's some challenges there for the Liberal Party going forward, as I've remarked tonight. I think for Daniel, there are very few premiers, as Charles said, that get three terms in a row. So, you know, he's in the history books, and he's full of energy and he's hungry to do things, and he'll implement the mandate. I do think it's going to be a challenging environment for any government in Australia, actually, over the next couple of years. It's just, you know, the global economy, what's happening with interest rates, what's happening with inflation, and that sort of widening gap between what Australians want and what they're prepared to pay for, I think is going to be a very challenging period for governments. But Daniel's got a very clear mandate. He'll get on with the job. And you heard tonight he's keen to work with all Victorians and try and bring Victorians back together, and that's what the state needs.
Yeah. Charles, our political editor.
Yeah, look, congratulations to Daniel Andrews. As we said, that's very rare. My thought, though, is with the Liberal Party. They have now lost six of the last seven here.
Yeah.
They've won three elections here since the 70s. There's been three on the trot in Queensland, three on the trot here, a wipeout in WA, a big result in South Australia, a loss federally. I mean, things are going badly. And they don't seem to be turning around. And it has to start somewhere. I mean, Sarah's on the panel and you'll be part of that rebuild, as you should be. And there is just a lot of soul searching is the word you've used to be done. You know, I remember of all people, we get our wisdom from Jay-Z. He always said that a loss ain't a loss, it's a lesson. Yeah. Lots of lessons for the Liberal Party now. The
just question take is, me through who's Jay-Z.
Have that moment. We'll play some music.
I think that's the perfect place to leave it, Charles. Thank you.
Jay-Z.
Us young people on the panel, we know who he is.
That's right.
Jeez. All right.